I'm Brant Allen. I'm a research biologist at UC Davis working at Lake Tahoe. I'm going to tell you a story about Mysis Shrimp. They are a small freshwater shrimp that ended up in Lake Tahoe because we put them there. They had some dramatic changes that they made.
So Mysis Shrimp were put into Lake Tahoe intentionally in the 1960s, and they were put in as a food resource for the game fish that live in the lake, mostly lake trout, but also kokanee salmon.
This is Lonnie, our pet Lahontan cutthroat trout. She was raised here at the Tahoe Environmental Research Center from an egg, and I am getting ready to feed her. So you notice how she's trying to catch her food? She uses her eyes to find the prey, and then swims up and eats it.
So you saw how Lonnie loved to feed on these Mysis shrimp that I put in the tank. And she keyed in on them with her eyes so she could find them and eat them. But out on the main lake, that doesn't happen because the Mysis shrimp are very sensitive to light. So during the daylight, right at sunrise, they swim more down really deep in the lake. And they're not available to the fish that need their eyes to find their food. So what you're looking at now is a Mysis shrimp. And you can notice it has really big eyes. As I said, they're really sensitive to light with these eyes. So they swim down deep in the lake to avoid the light. And what they also do by doing that is avoid predation by Tahoe fish. So if we go down deep in the lake now and look at them on the bottom, you can see them. This was filmed with a submersible and you see all of the shrimp sitting on the bottom, hiding out from the light. So when the Mysis came into the lake, it didn't work out so well as fish food. But the Mysis did a really good job of feeding on our native zooplankton. So they wiped out, they completely eliminated the Daphnia from Lake Tahoe. And Daphnia used to swim around and just clean up the lake by putting little particles and algae cells into their mouth and digesting them. The Daphnia disappearing from the lake had a big impact on the ecology of the lake, but also the clarity. The Daphnia are really good at eating these fine particles and algae that are in the lake. And that's what clouds our water. So we can't see down as far as there's really fine particles and algae. With the Daphnia gone, there was nobody to consume those, so our lake clarity was diminished as a result. We were fortunate enough to see an accidental experiment happening right in Emerald Bay in Lake Tahoe. We went in to look for Mysis shrimp, and they had disappeared. We still don't know why they disappeared, but their numbers were so low that it allowed the Daphnia to come back and populate Emerald Bay. And as a result, we had these Daphnia back in there feeding on small algae cells and feeding on fine particles, and the lake, the Emerald Bay portion of the lake, doubled in clarity. The clarity improved twofold. So for the past 2 years, researchers have been going into Emerald Bay and using a big net pulled behind the boat, trying to remove the Mysis shrimp. We wanted to see if we could recreate that natural experiment that we saw years before. So by reducing the Mysis shrimp, we're looking to see if we can have Daphnia come back and repopulate the bay and create that clearing effect once again. To do that, we're going out at night. And we go out at night with this big research boat, the big trawl behind it, and we pull it through the water and catch Mysis shrimp. So our big question is, can you actually remove enough Mysis from the bay to allow Daphnia to come back and naturally clean it up? The second question is, if you harvest all of these shrimp, what are you gonna do with them? Well, there's some really brilliant ideas about what to do with shrimp that come out of Lake Tahoe. They're very high in nutrient value in omega-3 fatty acids. That's the good part of the salmon that you eat when you eat the salmon that comes out of the ocean. So they would make an excellent product for either pets or humans and a really nice food resource where we could then use the shrimp that we used in this restoration project to another purpose. perhaps this lake clearing effort can actually fund itself. I hope you enjoyed your virtual tour of the Tahoe Science Center, and keep an eye out for more to come.